I invite the children who are receiving First Communion to please come forward up on the steps and have a seat on the steps. All right, boys and girls, you excited for your big day today?
Yeah.
Good. All right. I want to teach you a new word today, maybe a word that you haven't heard before. Have you ever heard of a word called ritual? Have you ever heard of a ritual? A ritual, you've heard it before? Do you know what it means?
I've heard it in a movie.
OK, you've heard that word before? Well, a ritual is when you repeat certain words or actions at special occasions. And we do all kinds of rituals in life without realizing it. We have certain times in life when we repeat certain things, we say certain words or do certain actions, and that is a ritual. For example, one ritual that I know you guys do a lot from time to time is, how many of you have ever been to a birthday party? You've been to everybody's been to birthday parties? Good. A birthday party is a kind of a ritual. We repeat certain words and actions every time you have a birthday party, right? For example, let's think of the things that we do at a birthday party and why is this so important. We do a birthday party, why? To celebrate what?
Somebody's birthday.
Yeah, somebody's birthday, and why do we celebrate that? You celebrate the day you were born, yeah, because you're celebrating another year of life. So a birthday party is a ritual that celebrates the gift of life. And we always do certain things at a birthday party as part of that ritual. For example, when you're at a birthday party, imagine it's your birthday right now. Imagine it's your birthday. Are you all by yourself at your birthday party?
No.
Who else is there?
Friends.
You invite your friends, yes. Who else do you invite?
Family.
You invite your family, yeah. You invite your family, your friends to come and celebrate with you. It's a birthday party, you need to have people there. Wouldn't be a very fun birthday party. Imagine if you were sitting in your room all by yourself on your birthday and you were like, yay me, woo-hoo, I'm another year older. And you just pat yourself on the back and there's no one else there. That wouldn't be fun, would it? No, you need to gather people together in the ritual of a birthday party. So a birthday party, you gather people together. And then at a birthday party, do you sing any songs?
Yeah.
What do you sing?
Yeah,
you gotta sing the happy birthday song. It's kind of like a law. I'm pretty sure you'd get arrested if you had a birthday party and didn't sing the happy birthday song. It's part of the ritual of a birthday. At a lot of birthday parties I go to, we don't just sing happy birthday. What's the other song you sometimes sing at a birthday party? Yeah, you're right. The how old are you song. I love to sing that song. Boys and girls, the next time you're at your grandparents' birthday party, make sure you sing the how old are you song. They love it. They love it when you sing the how old are you song at your parents' and grandparents' birthdays, okay? So we gotta sing songs at a birthday party, right? And then at a birthday party, so often when you gather your family and friends together, you know what always ends up happening? Is you end up sharing some family stories, do you not? Sometimes when you got grandma and grandpa there, or your mom and your dad, you share family stories. Sometimes at a birthday, do your parents ever tell you stories about when maybe you were little, maybe when you're a baby, or do your grandparents tell you stories about when they were little, what life was like for them when they were growing up, how they didn't have the internet or cell phones, when they had a question, they couldn't just ask Siri or Alexa, they had to look it up in a book. That was like ancient times, right? So at birthday parties, right, we tell our family stories. And that's kind of cool because when you tell those stories and you hear about your parents and your grandparents, it gives you a sense of belonging. It kind of tells you a little bit about your story when you hear your family stories as well. So at a birthday party, you gather people together, you sing songs, you tell your family stories, but then I'm forgetting something. There's something really important you still got to do. It doesn't count as a birthday party unless you do this. What? Oh, yeah, there's gifts. Yes, there's gifts, and? Yeah, you gotta eat something special, you're right. It wouldn't count as a birthday party if you didn't eat something special, right? You receive gifts, and you eat that birthday cake. You know, you light all the candles, you blow out the candles, and you eat something special. You know, you gather people together at a birthday party, you sing songs, you tell your family story, you eat something special. Those are really important things that make up the ritual of a birthday party to celebrate the gift of life. We also have a ritual that celebrates the gift of God's love in our lives. What ritual are we celebrating today? Yes, and that's all part of the, where right now we're at church to have the Mass. Yeah, we're at church to have the Mass. The Mass is a ritual that celebrates God's constant love and his presence in our life. Now let's think about some of the parts of the ritual of a Mass. Do we gather people together?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know.
Look behind you.
Oh, yeah. I love it. He just said, look behind you. Yeah, you're right. There's kind of a lot of people here, aren't there? Yeah. The first part of a Mass, you think about it, the first part of the ritual of the Mass, you gather people together. Yes, God wants us to pray by ourselves. We do have to pray a lot of times by ourselves. But God also wants his family to gather together. The church is like the big family of God. He wants us to gather together. We need to pray together regularly, be supported by each other, show our love to each other. So the first part of the ritual of the Mass, we gather together. Do we sing any songs at Mass?
Yeah.
What do we sing at Mass? We sing lots of church songs, lots of songs about?
God.
Yeah, songs about God. We praise God, we thank God, we ask God for things. Yes, we sing about Jesus, who's the Son of God. So we sing lots of songs at Mass. There was once a great saint named Saint Augustine who said, whoever sings, prays twice. That when we sing, we're praising God with our body and our soul. So at the Mass, we gather people together. We sing songs in prayer. Do we hear any stories at Mass? Where do we hear stories from?
You.
From me, yes. I tell stories, you're right. Yep. The Bible, yes, you're absolutely right. The first half of the Mass is where we listen to readings from the Bible. Think of the Bible as our family storybook. The Bible tells the stories of all the people that God has interacted with throughout all the years. The Bible's like our family story. It's like at a birthday party when your mom and your dad and your grandparents tell stories. At Mass, we hear from the Bible that tells how God has always been with his people and how much he loves us. So at the Mass, we hear stories. Do we receive anything special to eat? Yeah, what?
Wine and the bread.
The bread and the wine, yes. And that turns into, it's not just ordinary bread and wine, it becomes?
Jesus' body and Jesus' blood.
Very good, you've been taught so well. I gotta give a big pat on the back to your child minister. Where's Kristen? We gotta give her a big pat on the back. They got the most important question, right? Holy Communion is not just ordinary bread and wine. At Mass, it becomes the body and blood of Jesus. Because he wants to be so close to us that he gives us himself to feed on. Boys and girls, have you ever heard a phrase? When I was growing up, I sometimes heard this phrase, you are what you eat. Have you ever heard that? You've never heard that? Some of you have. You heard that? Maybe some of your moms and dads sometimes say that. Maybe sometimes your moms and dads say that, like, don't eat junk food. You don't want to, like, you know, fill your body with bad stuff. Sometimes you hear your mom or your dad say, you are what you eat. I always think about that at Mass, because Jesus wants us to feed on him so we become like him. We receive Jesus into our life in Holy Communion. Jesus wants us to think like him, act like him, feel like him, love like him. Jesus gives us himself in Holy Communion. So just like at a birthday party, I think you said it before, what did you receive at a birthday party?
Gifts,
yes. At Mass, we receive the greatest gift possible, Jesus himself in Holy Communion. What were you going to say? Okay. So we have this ritual, the Mass. We gather people together. We sing songs. We hear our family story in the scriptures. And Jesus gives us himself in Holy Communion, which you get to receive for the first time today. And that's why we're so excited and happy for you. At this time, I invite you to go back to your pews, and you're going to have your parents or godparents place your baptismal stole on you. You're about to receive a sacrament of initiation, so we're going to remember the very first sacrament you received, which was?
Baptism.
Yeah, so we're going to remember that. So if you can go back to your pews, your moms and dads and godparents will place your baptismal stole on you. And then boys and girls and Deacon Sandy, I invite you to please come back with me to the baptismal font. after you've placed your stole on.